Hey, it's Professor Dave. Let's talk about prime numbers.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
After learning about division, it's only natural to talk about the concept of divisibility. Numbers are only divisible by certain other numbers, which means that they can only be divided evenly in certain ways. Take the number 10. 10 can be divided by 1, which just gives 10. In this way, every number is divisible by 1. 10 is also divisible by 2, because it is an even number. Even numbers are the ones that are divisible by 2, like 2, 4, 6, 8, and so forth. However, 10 is not divisible by 3. If we try, we get 3 remainder 1. 3 does not go into 10 evenly. So while 1 and 2 are factors of 10, 3 is not. 4 also is not. 5 is a factor of 10 because 5 is half of 10. 10 divided by 5 is 2. So 5 is a factor of 10. But from there, no number bigger than half of the larger number will be a factor except the larger number itself. So 6, 7, 8, and 9 are out. And lastly, we say that 10 is a factor of 10 because 10 divided by 10 is 1. 1, 2, 5, and 10 are the factors of 10. How about 20? For 20, we see that 1 works, as always, 2 as well, because it's an even number. 3 does not, but 4 does, as well as 5. Then we jump all the way to 10, since it's half of 20, then 20 itself, and that's the end. Those are the factors of 20. This brings us to an obvious question. Are there any numbers that have no factors whatsoever? Technically, no, because any number will have as factors both 1 and itself. But what about beyond that? Are there any numbers that have no factors besides 1 and itself? There are indeed many, and numbers that fulfill this criterion are called prime numbers. What are the prime numbers? 1 doesn't count, because 1 and itself would be the same thing. So let's start with 2. 2 counts, as does 3, because these are so small that there can be no other factors. But once we get to 4, 4 is divisible by 2, so 4 is not a prime number. In fact, no even numbers, except for 2, can be prime numbers, because they are all divisible by 2. Only odd numbers can be prime numbers. 5 is a prime number, as is 7, but 9 is not, because it is divisible by 3. 11 works, as does 13, but not 15, since that's the product of 3 and 5. 17 works, and so does 19, but not 21, since that's 7 times 3. 23 works, and so on. One would think that this can't go very far, because once numbers get big enough, there have to be some factors in there. But there are some astoundingly huge prime numbers. The largest one discovered so far has millions of digits, which is mind-boggling, and it took thousands of computers running simultaneously for days to find this number. In fact, there are infinitely many prime numbers, so no matter how big the biggest one we've found, there's always a bigger one. So now that we know what prime numbers are, we can understand why we must factor numbers until only prime numbers remain, since that's the farthest we can go. Take 20, for example. We could represent that as 5 times 4, and 4 can be represented as 2 times 2. So factoring 20 gives us 5 times 2 times 2, which are all prime numbers. How about 36? We can split that into 9 times 4. 9 can be 3 times 3, and 4 can be 2 times 2, so 3 times 3 times 2 times 2. Notice how we are never done until we are left with all prime numbers. Let's try 90. First, we can get 9 times 10. Break that into 3 times 3 and 5 times 2, and there we go. What if instead we started with 30 times 3? 30 becomes 10 times 3, 10 becomes 5 times 2, and we end up with the same thing anyway. This is because there is only one unique set of prime factors for any number, and this important notion is called the fundamental theorem of arithmetic. Now that we've got the hang of prime factorization, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.